strong earnings growth in Europe still. We have seen a slightly decelerating tendency among the four regions, but still the EPS growth for European companies is quite strong at 46% compared to same time last year. A slightly decelerating tendency in the other regions. We have Japan, we have MSCI Emerging Markets and MSCI USA that are having a slightly lower EPS growth, but still the EPS numbers are favoring European companies that are still cheaper compared to US companies. Looking at the leading indicators for the four major regions in the world, we are seeing a decelerating tendency for Europe. We are seeing also a slightly decelerating tendency for Japan, but the US is still seeing the composite leading indicators from the OECD increasing. So apparently we haven't seen the best of US growth yet. We still could see some upward surprising figures for the US industrial production growth and for the GDP figures in the US. Regarding China, we have seen quite a significant drop in the leading indicators, but apparently that is stabilizing by now. So give it 1 or 2 months more, and we might have seen the beginning of an upward tendency in the CLI for China. We just saw yesterday the first estimate for the first quarter GDP growth in the Eurozone. They came out at 2.5%. That's the green line here. The blue line is the high frequency indicator from Bloomberg, which is giving you a hint on where to expect the realized growth figures to come out. Still, the high frequency figure is suggesting a somewhat higher growth. So once we see the final and revised figures for the first quarter growth in Europe, those might be slightly higher than the current estimate of 2.5%. That's probably also why we saw the revision of the fourth quarter figure being revised higher from 2.7 to 2.8% yesterday. 10-year rates, they continue to edge higher in the US. They just broke the 3% level. That is not really the case in Europe. We see the German 10-year rates here. They are more or less flat, and that means that the spread, which is the gray line here, has just been edging higher and higher to the advantage of US investors. Well, not the ones that are already invested, but the ones that will invest in US 10-year rates, or 10-year bonds. It's just continuing to edge higher, and that is kind of an anomaly in the FX market where if you see the 10-year rate spread increasing to the advantage of the US dollar, then you typically would see that the US dollar would increase, and that is not something we've seen until very recently. But now the euro dollar is actually beginning to drop, so that's a kind of a normalization of the patterns in the rates and FX markets. Looking slightly ahead in the Eurozone, our model for industrial production growth is suggesting that we are going to see a forceful deceleration over the next 12 months. From the currently accelerating tendency, the red one is the realized figures. So in the past year or so, we have seen a gradual accelerating tendency in the growth rate in the industrial production in the Eurozone. But over the next 12 months or so, we're going to see a forceful deceleration going into the spring of 2019. So not only will the second half of 2018 be relatively soft, that is going to continue into 2019. So that is probably why we are seeing this spread in 10-year rates, that the US 10-year rates are continuing to edge higher while the German 10-year rates are more or less flat. Looking at the equity allocation, I'm continuing to have a neutral allocation there. On the one hand side, the CLI, or the composite leading indicators from the OECD, has topped and is now dropping, which is more or less negative for the equity markets. But our own and proprietary momentum and volatility indicator is still above the threshold of 0.6, where under which you should have an underweight to equities, and over which you have an overweight. So the one balanced out with the other, and that's why I am continuing to have a neutral stance on equities over the next month.